can we love each other? Before we discard it, can you just say, can we love each other?
Can we love each other?
Can you ask it out your mouth, can we love each other?
Can we love each other?
If you will stand to your feet and join me in the book of John for just a moment, John chapter 15. John chapter 15, starting at verse 9. And I'll read you verse 17. Listen to the words of your Lord Jesus. And he says, I have loved you. Woo! He said, I have loved you. Wait a minute. It is one thing for him to love you when your hair was good and you smelled beautiful and you looked good. But no. He's talking about I loved you when you was in the middle of your mess. I'm talking about when you was in the midst of your filth. I'm talking about when you were crawling around and nobody wanted to get close to you. He said, I have loved you just as the Father has loved me. And he says, abide in my love. Continue in his love with me. Everybody say, with me. If you keep my commandments, if you continue to obey my instructions, you will abide in my love and live on in it. Just as I have obeyed my Father's commandments and live on in his love. He says, I have told you these things that my joy and delight may be in you. Somebody say in you.
Amen.
And that your joy and gladness may be a full measure and complete and overflowing. Wait a minute, I need to just stop right there. Because if you got a joy deficiency in your life, if you got some gladness that ain't really popping off like it's supposed to in your life, maybe you need to check your love meter. This is my commandment, verse 12. This is my commandment that you love one another. Look at somebody say, can we love each other? Just as I have loved you. Watch what he says. No one has greater love. No one has shown a stronger affection than to lay down, give up his own life for his friends. Then he continues, he says, you are my friends. If, I say if, you are my friends, if you keep on doing the things which I command you to do. Can we turn that around? He says, you my friend, if. If you keep on doing what I have commanded you to do. He said, I do not call you servants, slaves any longer. For the servant does not know what his master is doing or working out. But I have called you my friend. Somebody say, my friend. Because I have made known to you everything that I heard from my Father, and I have revealed to you everything that I have learned from him. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and I have appointed you, and I have planted you that you might go and bear fruit and keep on bearing, and that your fruit may be lasting, that it may remain abide. So that whatever you ask the Father in my name, as presenting all that I am, he may give it to you. This is what I command you, that you love one another. Before you be seated, can you just turn to somebody one more time and say, can we love each other?
Can we love each other?
Be seated in the presence of the Lord. I don't think that believers, come on, I got 15 minutes to do this. I don't think that believers really understand the power of loving each other. I don't think believers have really tapped into the secret source of blessings that are associated with loving each other. I don't think that believers have really understood and completely came to the true revelation that, hey, I can unlock a
another realm of blessings just by loving somebody else.